Sit up straight, head up. You're not crushed, you're not defeated. Because we are practicing liberation from what? From hallucination, actually. The belief that we're entrapped is a hallucination. And one does not get free of hallucination by taking the hallucination as real and then defeating it. One has to take this leap of faith that this is only a hallucination and then say, I already know that this incarceration already appears as indescribably vast, calmly radiant spaciousness. Indescribably vast, calmly radiant spaciousness. I already know this. So you deny the hallucination and you state what's actually there. What's actually there. Now, I've been practicing this morning after a very intense inquiry into, and I found what I found myself in this most hideous incarceration in some vast, deep, like salt mine, in some tiny, crammed into some tiny little nook, like a piece of trash under this billions and billions and billions of tons of solid, you know, compacted ice crystals, like this incredibly deep tomb. You know, when you, sometimes you put people in a tomb, you put all this ice, rock, salt around them, and so they don't, so it dries out or something. It's like I was like in this, you know, billions underneath billions of tons of solid rock, compacted rock crystal, and just stuffed into a crack there, and left there. This is how I feel. This is how I felt my whole life, like this. Starting from the point where a delusion grabbed hold, this is how I've actually felt. So I was able to see where I felt I was, finally. And oh, it was, you know, just horrifying. But through these practices that I've been doing, I already know the new appearance of this tree. I already know new appearance of this shrub. I already know this new appearance of this bush. I already know the new appearance of this tree, ground. I already know this new appearance of the sky. Practicing this yesterday, I had enough courage to see how I felt and where I thought I was. And this is where I have believed I am, is in this extreme and deep tomb, incarcerated underneath this impenetrably vast and heavy and compacted, like rock crystals. And I'm just lying there, like dead, but I'm not dead. But I'm like incarcerated, alive there, with no possibility. You know, it's just hopeless, absolutely hopeless. And so I said, okay, let's just look at this. I'm not despairing, I'm not giving up. There's an answer to this. And somehow I was able to, through the grace of Holy Spirit, grace of the teachers, the examples of normalcy, to start practicing. And I said, let's just start practicing. So I said, I know, I already know. I already know that this, the new appearance of this rock crystal as boundless, indefinably vast, radiantly pure spaciousness. I already know this new appearance of this entombment, this trappedness. I already know the new appearance of entrappedness as radiantly spacious, vastness, indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the appearance of trappedness as indescribably vast spaciousness. And I began practicing that. And I found, instead of feeling like I was crammed into this wedge, in this crack, in this, I felt like I was now sort of standing in this room. There's a little bit of room to stand there. And then I kept doing this, and then I began to see that, like, some parts of this vast entombment were gone. And you could see spaciousness there. So, and then I began to realize that this entire and hideous entombment was a hallucination. In fact, all entrapment is a hallucination. And that the real appearance is this indescribably vast, radiant spaciousness. That's the real appearance. And so, all we have to do is begin asserting and affirming that I already know the real appearance of this entrapment is this vast spaciousness, vast, indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the real appearance of all things. I already know the real appearance of everything is already this vast, indescribably vast spaciousness. So I've already been working on this, and so I, having now understood that we are actually trying to entrap God by believing that it's possible for God to be entrapped, and we do this by entrapping ourselves, believing it's possible to entrap ourselves, and so we imagine this incredibly hideous entrapment, believing that this proves that God can be trapped, and yet we're entrapped in it. But it's all a hallucination, because God cannot be trapped. Nothing can be trapped. The nature of everything, the appearance of everything, is an indescribably vast spaciousness. So I already know the appearance of the severe entrapment as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the appearance of this entrapment as indescribably vast spaciousness. That's how it's appearing to me now. I already know the appearance of this massive rock salt, this massive rock salt, as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the appearance of all things as this indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the appearance of all flesh as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the appearance of this thing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the new appearance of this thing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the new appearance of this vast entrapment as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the appearance of this world as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this world has the appearance now of indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this world now appears as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this vast entombment now appears as indescribably vast spaciousness. Okay, this is how to practice. This is how to deal with hallucinations. I already know that this world, appearing now as indescribable vaspaciousness. I already know this world's appearance as. This world already appearing as vast spaciousness. I already know this world already appearing as vast spaciousness. I already know this massive entombment as already appearing as vast spaciousness. I already know this extreme trappedness as already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Severe trappedness is already appearing as this vast, indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this trappedness is already appearing as this vast space, indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this severe entrapment is already appearing as this indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this. This trappedness is already appearing as vast, indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this entrapment is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know that this hideous entrapment is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know that this tree is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree already appearing as vast, indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree's appearance as. I already know this tree's appearance as indescribably vast spaciousness. Trying to find the right practice here. I already know this tree is already appearing as vast spaciousness. I already know this entrapment is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know this entrapment is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this severe entrapment. I already know this vast entrapment's appearance as already indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree's appearance as already indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree's appearance appearing. I already know this tree appearing as already indescribably vast spaciousness. So just, it's okay to try to struggle with this and keep looking at it here. I already know this tree is already indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree's appearance as already indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this entrapment's appearance as already indescribably vast spaciousness. Yeah, I already know this trappedness, this entombment's appearance as already indescribably vast spaciousness. To just settle it. It's struggling a little bit here. I already know that this entrapment is now appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this all things are now appearing. The new appearance of all things is indescribably vast spaciousness. So I can't quite remember how to put this together. That's okay. Maybe it's just too much wow factor going on right now. That kind of, you know, confuses, a little bit stuns the mind, but we have to work through that. I said before, but I already know this tree's new appearance. Yeah, I already know this tree's already has this new appearance. Tree already has this new appearance. I already know this entrapment already has this new appearance as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yeah, I already know that all things already have this new appearance as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree already has this new appearance as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know these shrubs already have this appearance as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this tree already has the appearance of indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know the world already has the appearance of indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this entombment already has the appearance of indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this table already has the appearance of indescribably vast spaciousness. Yeah, this is the practice, okay. I already know this table already has the appearance of indescribably vast spaciousness. So we've taken this leap of faith, this tremendous leap of faith. Instead of struggling with the hallucination, when the hallucination appears to be so hideous that we feel that we must struggle with it, but we're not. We're not. We're practicing. I already know. This table. This table is already appearing. I already know this table is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this extraordinary, extreme entombment is already appearing as indescribably vast, calmly radiant spaciousness. Indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this entombment. Okay, so this is a breakthrough. This is a monumental breakthrough. Able to get myself to practice in this way instead of bemoaning my fate, which is definitely based on yesterday's breakthrough, which just shook me up so extraordinarily. If we want to entrap God, make God lesser so that we seem greater, and therefore find some way to entrap God in something lesser, we have to first imagine this lesser condition, and then we have to prove to ourselves that it's capable of entrapping us in order to believe it can entrap God. So we're in this tomb of entrapment of our own imagination in order to try to prove that we can entrap God. And yet we believe we're so hideously entrapped that we're just lying there like completely distraught and freaked out under, you know, miles of billions of tons of super compressed rock salt in this dark, utterly forgotten place where nobody has the slightest idea where we could possibly be. And so we're imagining, if God was here, then God would be entrapped. You see, this is what we're thinking. And yet, we feel we're entrapped. So we've entrapped ourselves in what? In a hallucination. In our imagination. And that's not really entrapment at all, is it? So, what is actually here? I know, I already know, this table is already appearing as, I already know this table is already appearing as indescribably vast, calmly radiant spaciousness. Smoothly radiant spaciousness. This indescribably vast, smooth, radiant spaciousness. I already know the table is already appearing as this indescribably vast, radiant spaciousness. I already know. So, we practice on easy, simple things first, which is what I did yesterday. And then I was able to apply it to this feeling of massive entrapment. Okay, so, we have the tools of freedom. We have the tools, it's just a matter of using them. Which is why I say practice, practice, practice is the way. So whenever anyone would ask me a question, the only response I would have back is, well, what do you want to practice? What is it that you want to practice? That's what we have to get to. That's what we have to find out. In each moment, what is it that we're capable of practicing? Even to generate a little will to practice. I know we feel inconsolably lost and buried and forgotten about. Yet we do have to summon up our will to do some practice, because we don't want to stay in this condition forever. It's an imagined condition, but our imagination can be extraordinarily persuasive to us. So, I already know. Yeah, yes, I already know. This table is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know this ground is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this walkway is appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know this tree is already appearing. Yes, I already know this tree is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that house is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that that wall is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that that car is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that that flower is appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that that debris is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this can is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that that glass is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this bottle is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this sky is already appearing as in. I already know that this sky is already appearing as vast, indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, of course I already know that this branch is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that these leaves are already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that these lights are already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all things are already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this whole entire world is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this vast, heavy, dark entrapment is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this vase is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that wastebasket is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that this post is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that this seat is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that this day is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. It's already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that everything is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Now, full stop in the wow. This is starting to, you know, just like, wow. Yes. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that this moment is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know this instant is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that those rocks are already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. So anything and everything that isn't already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness is actually a hallucination of entrapment. It's actually a hallucination of entrapment. And since it's just a hallucination, we simply say, yes, I know that this hallucination is already appearing as indescribable vastness. Yes, I know that all hallucinations are already appearing as indescribably vast. Spaciousness, indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that all hallucinations are already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. a severe tingling in my nose. Just wow. Tickling, severe tickling, or tingling and tickling in the nose. I was like, holy, wow, very intense. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. Yes, of course, I already know that all hallucination is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that all entombment is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. And of course, we're just transitioning to normal here, aren't we? I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. We're just transitioning to normal here. Again, this severe tickling is happening in the nose. Like you want to touch the nose, but no. Oh, man. Do not touch the nose. This is one of the things. Full stop and then out. Do not touch your face. There will be all sorts of things come up that you feel like I just have to. Oh, a severe impulse to scratch the nose. Oh. Good Lord. It's like you feel like you have to. You can't resist. Oh. Like it's some imperative. Still going on. It's moving the different parts of the nose. Now it's on the side more. So this is part of full stop in the wow. Sometimes you get these physical reactions of like tickling or you need to scratch it. Or there's something moving around that you've got to get rid of. What is that, a bug there or something? No. Or sneeze, a sensation, some sort of bedeviling sensation that you need to attend to. And the full stop now is that you absolutely will not. Whoa, it just hit me again harder. Good Lord. I know this itch is already, I already know this itch is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know all sensation is already appearing as indescribably vast, smoothly radiant spaciousness. Indescribably vast. No way to describe it. The vastness, the vast spaciousness is so vast. No way to describe it. I already know all sensation is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know that all sensation is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. Indescribably calm. Radiantly calm. indescribably vast space, just radiantly calm. And now the other side of the nose is starting to get this sensation. Wow. First it was the left side, now it's the right side. I already know that all sensation is already appearing as indescribably calm, vast spaciousness. It's almost like you have to put yourself in a straitjacket not to respond, but you have to use your will to the utmost here. Definitely causes a strain in the body to resist this. Because the reactions are screaming, react, 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 you gotta react. Say no, no, no. I already know that all incarceration is already appearing as indescribably vast liberation. In this completely smooth, undefinable, vast spaciousness. I already know that all incarceration is already appearing as this indescribably vast, luminous spaciousness. I already know that all incarcerations are already appearing as this indescribably vast spaciousness. So you see, this the wow really hit here. So when it really hits, like, maintain your posture, attentive, undefeated, attentive, not bowed, head up, not undefeated, there's no defeat here whatsoever, standing your ground entirely. Stand your ground. I already know that all incarcerations are already appearing as indescribably vast, beautifully luminous, serenely smooth calmness. I already know that all incarcerations are already appearing as this indescribable vastness, vast spaciousness. Yeah, I already know that all incarcerations are already appearing as this indescribably vast spaciousness, smoothly calm, luminous peace. Stand your ground. Full stop in the wow, stand your ground. So there is something to the postures. There is something. It helps a little bit. Or what I would say is stand your ground posture. Stand your ground. You're not aggressive. You're not passive aggressive. Either one. You're simply full stop in the wow. So I'm not backing off one bit from these affirmations. I may be temporarily stunned, but I'm not backing off this one bit. No matter what anything appears to be, I am not backing off this one bit. If you want, you can be in anything that gives you this feeling. I'm just sitting. Sometimes you put your feet flat on the floor, like this, hands on your legs, our hands together, are just sort of just sitting there. The hands are just calmly there. Arms resting on the legs. Very solid stance like this. I'm not giving any ground at all. Not attacking, not retreating. Just solidly right here. This is all just a base for the head. The main thing is to keep your head up. Don't slump. Not resigned to any fate here. We're not resigned to any fate. I know. Yeah, I know. All fate is already appearing as absolutely luminous, indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know that. Yeah, I already know that all fate is appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. I already know that all fate is already appearing as indescribably vast spaciousness. This is not an arrogant, haughty poise or anything. It's just a solid, no back down from the facts stance. That's it. Just relaxed. We're not tense. We're not aggressive. And we're not slack, like passive, defeated. We're not, neither one. I already know that all fate is already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. I already know that all fate is already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all destiny is already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all tendencies are already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all habits are already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. I already know this. So it's a stance of, I already know this. See, yes, I already know this. Yes, I already know that all fate is already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. I already know that all tendencies are already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all desires are already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all imagination is already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. I tend to do this with eyes open. I've always tended to practice with eyes open. Because when you close the eyes, there's a tendency to start, you can easily fall into all sorts of thinking and thoughts and this and that. No, we're just stating fact here, that's all. We don't need to do anything other than that. Yes, I already know that all fate is already spontaneously vast spaciousness. I already know that all of these things are already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that I am already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all is already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as spontaneously vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that all future lives are already appearing as already appearing as spontaneous vast spaciousness, spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all past lives are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Yes, yes, I already know that all possible lives are already arising as vast spontaneous spaciousness. Already appearing as spontaneous vast spaciousness. Yes, I know that all possible lives are already appearing as spontaneous vast spaciousness. Yes, yes, I already know that all possible lives are already appearing as spontaneous, spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all possible lives are already appearing as spontaneous vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all possible appearances are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Gets to be too much. Just I keep your posture like this. I'm not backing down one bit. I'm standing my ground, absolutely. And I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Yes, I already know that all possible appearances are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast luminous spaciousness. Yes, 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 I already know that this universe, all of this universe is already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Of course I already know that this entire universe is already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Got hit by irritation, they're strong. Oh, now it's gone to the nose. First it hit the throat right here. Strong, piercing irritation in the throat. And it shot up to my nose. Oh. Yes, I know that all, yes. Yes, I already know that all irritation is already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all possible sensations are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast, luminous, smoothed out spaciousness. Mm. Now, is there a spiritual buzz going on here? Absolutely there is. So you maintain the posture, maintain the discipline, maintain full stop in the wow. You understand now why full stop in the wow is so important, because these affirmations are so intense. Of course you have to be disciplined. Yes, I already know that all possible sensations are already appearing as spontaneously arising, smoothed out, clear, vast, indefinably, indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know that all sensations are already appearing as spontaneously arising, totally smooth, indescribably vast, clear, luminously calm, spaciousness, spaciousness, spaciousness. Yes, yes, I already know that all possible reactions are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all perceptions are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all perceptions are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. So you see, our attitude, we're saying that, yes, I already know it. Yes, I already know this. I already know this. This is what I'm already seeing. I already know this. Yeah. It's already apparent. This, yeah, of course. Yes, this is already apparent. Yes, I already know. That all reactions are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast, pure spaciousness. So this is the attitude. I already know this. This keeps us very centered and grounded, standing our ground. We are abiding in what we already know. Yes, I already know that all practices are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast, smooth spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all practices are already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast, pure, smooth spaciousness. I already know. Yes, I already know that all practices are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure, clear, smooth spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all technique is already appearing as spontaneously arising vast, indescribably vast, smooth, clear spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all techniques are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, smooth, clear spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all processes are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, smooth, clear spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all details are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, smooth, clear spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all thoughts are already arising, already appearing. Yes, I already know that all thoughts are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, smooth, clear spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all possibilities are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, smooth, clear spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all circumstances are already appearing as spontaneously arising pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all situations are already appearing as spontaneously arising pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all existence is already appearing as spontaneously arising pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all hallucination is already appearing as spontaneously arising pure spaciousness. See, this is very important to say, I already know. Yes, I already know. Very important. Very important. This is a little trick that we use, you see, to succeed. And the truth is, we do already know. We've just forgotten that we already know, you see. So the little trick is, we don't try to remember that we already know. We assert, we affirm the truth that we do already know. Like, let's say, like, there's a fact you already know is true, and you've temporarily forgotten it. Do you struggle? Say, oh, I can't remember. I gotta go look for where is it? No, you say, no, I already know this. I know I already know it. So why am I struggling? I know it's within me. I know I already know it. So I'm not going to frantically struggle to go find it somewhere. I already have it. I already have it. It's already within me. I don't need to look externally for it. So yes, I already know. Yes, I already know that all ignorance is already appearing as spontaneously arising vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all forgetting is already appearing as spontaneously arising pure spaciousness. Spontaneously arising vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all forgetting is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Hold your ground, full stop in the wow, hold your ground. Spiritual Marines, hold your ground. The day sees this moment, hold your ground. I already know. Yes, I already know.
Thank you.
I already know. Yes, I already know that all beliefs already appear. Yes, I already know that all beliefs already appear, are already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably fast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all beliefs are already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all traditions are already appear. Yes, I know that all traditions already appear as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all resistance already appears as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all mockery is already appearing as in spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all rejection is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all no's are already appearing. All no's are already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably a vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all denial is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all denial is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure smooth calm spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all spiritual pride is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all arrogance is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all certitude is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all certitude is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure, luminous, calm, smooth, beautiful spaciousness. And the wow is so strong, I don't even remember what I just said, but it was very great, yeah. Yes, I already know that all certitude is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast, smooth, clear, radiantly beautiful, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all affirmations are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know that all words are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all expression is already arising as spontaneously, is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all positions are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all points of view are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all the denunciations are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all ravings are already appearing as spontaneously arising vast, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all insanity is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all insanity is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all liberation is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Are you buzzing yet? Do you have a spiritual budget? Do you have a wow yet? Absolutely, full stop in the wow. Well, stand your ground. Hold your ground. Yes, I already know that all enlightenment is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all attainment is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all results are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all breakthroughs are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all realizations are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all possible realizations are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Hold your ground. Hold your ground, spiritual marine. Hold hold your ground. Full stop in the wow. Yes, I already know that all wowness is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all wowness is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Hold your ground. Try not to rock back and forth. Yeah, that can get, that can happen, but try not to rock back more. Just stay steady like a rock. Hold your ground. This is really burning. Yeah, this is intense. Of course, this is our purpose, right? Yes, I already know that all purpose is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all design is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I know that all life is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Hold your ground, full stop on the wow, hold your ground. Yes, I know that all explanation is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all learning is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I know that everything is already appearing as indescribable, spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Hold your ground. Yes, I already know that all spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness already appearing as spontaneously rising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Hold your ground. Yes, I already know that nothing is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I know. Yes, I already know that all death is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure, smooth, beautifully luminous, pure, pure, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all death is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all decay is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all darkness is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I know that all light is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all activity is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all non-activity is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all attitude is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yeah, I'm feeling the strain, there's no question. Holding my ground, but you know, wow. This might be enough for now. I mean, I could go on. Yes, I already know that all beginnings and all endings are already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. So, just to now, okay, we're going to full stop in the wow, there's just a little bit. Keep your posture, hold your ground. And we could say, yes, I already know that all bliss is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all relief is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. All relief. Yes, I already know that all joy is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, spontaneously arising. Yes, I know that all love is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all freedom is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all reality is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all that is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Try not to sway. I'm starting to sway. Don't sway. Hold your ground. All thanks to Holy Spirit, Jesus, Longchenpa, Ramana Maharshi, train on the Mai and everyone else. All praise, all thanks to. In particular, I will say Longchenpa for seeming to inspire this particular practice. And Ramon Maharshi, who I was paying attention to last night, who also seemed to inspire this practice, and Jesus, who has I've been paying attention to as far as practicing, who's inspiring this practicing. This is inspired practice. Certainly recognize elements of Longchenpa's help here, absolutely. And Ramana Maharshi, absolutely. And Jesus Christ, absolutely. And the verification that these teachers are legitimate by Sri Anandamayi, who was for me the great verifier that these great teachers did exist, and they did teach truly, and they did come to the world, and all this is attainable. Great verifier of that. We know that Ramon Maharshi came, don't we? We can't get around that one, can we? We know that Sri Sri Anandamayi was here, right? We can't get around that. We know that there are these great radical Dzogchen Chen teachings, right? We can't get around that. We know that there's this wonderful A Course in Miracles and Journey Beyond Words teaching. We can't get beyond that, can we? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. That's plenty to have faith. That's plenty, and that's enough to have a leap of faith. Absolutely it is. Longchenpa appeared to me in a dream, first in the dream that he appeared, and had this red cross on his chest, and it signified both lifeguard and red cross, meaning medic on a battlefield. You know, the red cross is when you go in, like in a war zone, you have the red cross on you, showing that you're a non-combatant, that you're here to treat the wounded. All right, here to treat the wounded. So he came here willing to be on this battlefield, here to help the wounded, or the spiritually wounded, those who are suffering terribly from this imagined entrapment. And he brings with him this wonderful understanding of how to get past this gap, how to take this leap of faith in this type of practicing, the spirit of this type of practicing, leading to the, is definitely part of it, you see. So being able to accept this type of practicing is definitely in part because Longchenpa came back into this time frame somehow, spiritually present. In my request for some help, any help, I said, please, any help that can be given, I don't care who it is, please help. And this is who showed up. This is called like a bodhisattva, a type of functioning. This is who showed up. As a medic on a battlefield, saying, "Yeah, I'll drag you off the battlefield and put you in a nice hospital so you can recover," you know. And in that hospital, what is the hospital? A spiritual hospital of what? Affirmation, right affirmation, right spiritual practice. This is what we're doing here. So certainly, there are elements of inspiration from Longchenpa being incorporated into this practice, as well as elements of inspiration from Jesus being incorporated in this, as well as elements of inspiration from Ramana Maharshi being incorporated in this practice. Those are the three elements of inspiration. And then the faith to do that is being boosted by Sri Sri Anandamayi, saying, because of all the miracles that she demonstrated here, that demonstrated this is all true, this is absolutely all true, and this physicality is nothing but a mirage, and none of it's true at all, it's all hallucination. She demonstrated this through incredible number of miracles that was witnessed by so many. You see, so that's an overall boost to the faith. But the structure of the practice is inspired by Jesus, Ramana Maharshi, and Longchenpa. You might say the structure is more Longchenpa and Jesus, and there's an assurance from Ramana Maharshi, and then the verification by Sri Sri Anandamayi in practical, pragmatic verification of it. There's a pragmatic verification, there's a spiritual verification by Ramana Maharshi, who's in the silence, everything had resolved into this absolute, spontaneously arising, absolute, indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Ramana Maharshi showed that indeed everything is appearing as that. Sri Sri Anandamayi showed that pragmatically, in the functioning in this world, all of this can be demonstrated and shown to be true, and nothing interferes with it. Nothing interferes with it. Okay, that. But the structuring of the practicing is coming from Jesus and Longchenpa, those two. So Jesus has helped build up the practice. Jesus has done all the background work to build up the discipline. And then Longchenpa comes in with the expertise of how to do this highest type of practice. So the absolute, you know, pinnacle of greatness in radical Dzogchen teaching, Longchenpa, total master of it. No one better to advise us and inspire us on this. Someone who's absolutely detached from any tradition whatsoever, really. Completely transcending all practice, all tradition, everything. Knowing already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Credit. Yes, I know that all credit is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I know that all acknowledgement is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I know that God is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. So even when you're resting, hold your ground. Don't go into slouch land. Slouch land is an expression of trappedness. And I absolutely am aware. And know, I know the terribleness of our imagined entrapment, how terrible it can become, to indescribably terrible, yes. So, that's why I take this so seriously. I know it's not something to joke around about in terms of how severe can this imagined trappedness be and the suffering it brings out. Indescribably horrible, to the point where you feel completely hopeless. At least you're trying to feel completely hopeless. You're imagining that you're completely hopeless. And yet it is still your imagination, which means it's a dream. And the dreamer is not incapacitated at all. But certainly the dreamer can dream a dream of what seems to be total, complete incapacitation, hopeless incapacitation, absolutely entombed in hopeless incapacitation. This is what I've experienced. So that when I called out for help, Longchenpa showed up. He knows that you can feel so extremely wounded like this, and said, yeah, I'll help. Absolutely, I'll help. Absolutely, I'm capable of helping. And I want to help. He's one of compassionate help, you know, wanting to help. This is the compassion. Yeah, I want to help. This is my joy. This is my joy to do this. This is with Longchenpa. This is my joy to do this. He's not asking for any credit. Again, I already know that all credit is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Now, there may be some in the world who you know, but there also may be some who say, hey, I'm hearing this. I'm hearing it. I'm hearing what you're saying. I'm feeling it. And get serious about their own freedom, you know, from this imagined entrapment. Because the imagined entrapment will continue on until you realize that all imagined entrapment is already appearing as spontaneously rising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. All imagined entrapment is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. In fact, all imagination is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. So again, great thanks to Longchenpa. He didn't have to show up. I didn't know him. I had no knowledge of Longchenpa. I wasn't someone worshiping him. I wasn't someone who said, please, Longchenpa, show. I had no idea. I never heard of Longchenpa before. I just put out a plea, a total plea, 360-degree plea, for if there's anyone who wants to help and can help, please help, please help. We are really, really in bad shape here. The situation's in such bad shape. The battlefield is so intense here, and it's not going well for us, you know. And so this someone shows up. I had no idea who it was. But showed up ready with the Red Cross on, lifeguard tank top shirt on, said, I'm here. And then gave indications that they were absolutely capable of helping out. I said, wow, thank you. I don't know who you are, but thank you for showing up. And then gradually I was shown that this is who it is, Longchenpa, and how supremely capable he is of this type of practice, which is what we're doing. This is a very advanced, the highest type of practice, actually. It is the highest type of practice, this type of practice. requiring the greatest maturity, the greatest discipline, you know, the full stop and the wow. I understand if some feel it's like, well, this is so difficult. Yeah, well, you know, be a spiritual marine, hold your ground. You can hold your ground. You can do it. Yeah, I already know that all difficulty is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast per spaciousness. See, I already know this. So it's only a matter of taking this little leap of faith that we're helping you with, okay? Once you take this leap of faith, yeah, I already know, this attitude, you can do it. You can do it. You can do this. But this little faith is necessary. This little leap of faith is necessary. And this is what Jesus has said. All praise to Jesus for his indescribably great help. Can't even describe it. He says, there will come a point of time in your practicing on your path where it seems that it is necessary to take a leap of faith. What seems to be like a leap of faith. Absolutely. And we're at that point. And I realized, I got to that point, realized I got to do it. And so this little trick, the Holy Spirit says, try it. And this came about right around just before the beginning of 2015. And I said, 2015, the next 18 months starting then through June 21st, 2016. We're going to have to get after it and succeed here. And so this little leap of faith was necessary. But once you take that little leap of faith and start practicing it, you will be able to succeed. You will be able to do this. Well, it's only been like what for me? Like a month and a half, you see. It's already only been a month and a half doing this practice. And look where I'm at right now, able to practice in this way. So, yeah, it isn't necessary to take this leap of faith. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. It is necessary. Otherwise, of course, the struggle will just, you know, wheels will come off. Absolutely, they will. There's no question about it. I'm not going to dispute that at all. So, of course, I cannot help those do this practice without that leap of faith, without taking this a priori position. No, that's going to be impossible. So, if you haven't been able to take this a priori position, yes, I already know. We'll keep working on that. Absolutely, absolutely, very important. Yes. We'll keep working on that. And for those who have already taken the as far as conflating the whole thing. Yes, I already know that all conflations are already appearing as spontaneously rising in indescribably vast pure spaciousness. All conflations. And all, yes, I know that all praise is already appearing as spontaneously rising in indescribably vast pure spaciousness. All conflation, all praise, all comment. Yes, I know that all commentary, all comments are already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. And not to forget, yes, I already know that all music is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I know that all songs are already appearing as of spontaneously arising, indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all sound is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast pure spaciousness. So we're going like our house is on fire. I'm going like my hair is on fire, you know. I'm practicing like my hair is on fire. Because it is. Now, so what is the difference between this high practice, for instance, for example, radical Dzogchen and the rest of the Buddhist path, for instance? It is this little trick of a priori, yes, I already know. Yes, I already know this. This is it. This is the difference. This is the difference towards still grinding it out on the spiritual path and actually finishing. This is the difference. And it is like a leap of faith. Seems that way. And it takes us beyond the intellect, right? It dismisses the intellect. It says like, hey, intellect, shh, I already know. Yeah, I already know this. This is what it's all about. Is you say, yes, I already know this. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. So the intellect is already out of the picture now. Finished. You're done with it. Don't need it anymore. Yes, you just need to assert, remind yourself what you already know. Yes, I already know that all intellect is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all conceptualization is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Saturated. Wow. The suggestion came yesterday, like, hey, maybe we should go down to Pebble Beach and watch Buster Posey and Nick Watney try to win the, you know, AT&T. it's like the best day. I mean, it's like, they say it's the best day. Yesterday is the best day there's ever been there. And today is probably even better. And everybody is just like drunk on, you know, beauty of nature, so to speak, but it's all relative because usually it's like terrible there at this time, windy and cold and foggy and it's just like horrible. So they're saying, wow, it's so nice. And not to leave out, yes, I already know that nature is already appearing as indescribable, as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Yes, I know that all of nature, yes, I already know that all of nature is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. Okay? So, I said, you know, I think I'm gonna stay here and keep working. My hair's on fire, the house is on fire, the world's on fire. And been there and done that at Pebble Beach. So, I'm gonna stay here and tape. Wise decision. Wise decision. You know what was the decider? I don't have any money. That's the real decider. And I don't feel so good. I said, hey, don't forget the fact that I don't feel so good. The coffee and egg. And I don't, you know, I've been still ill, but I feel better today. So I don't have the energy and I don't have the money. Great, I can't go. And look what's happened. So, and I've said many ways, not having any money can be a great help because you got no choice just to practice. I mean, if I had money for sure, I would be doing all sorts of stuff that I, you know, gallivanting about in beautiful nature. I don't even have the money to drive anywhere, go anywhere, stay here, nothing. So all I can do is sit here and practice. But look at the benefit of that. It's like being in a cave in the Himalayas in the winter or whatever. There's nothing to do. You can't go anywhere. It's too cold. It's just sit in the cave by a little fire and practice. That's it. Well, what good would money do you in a cave in the Himalayas and Tibet or something? What good would money? You got a pile of gold. What good is that going to do? Nothing. Can't even spend it on either. Nowhere to go anywhere. Anyway, so. But here, you know, if you have money, oh my gosh, the world's your oyster. So, by not having any money. If I had money, I'd probably be in Hawaii right now or something, you know, sitting on the beach of Waikiki. Just luxuriating in the water or something, you know, playing golf or something. No, no. Health's not good enough to do it. No money to do it. I can't even go to a store and buy anything. So I can't even go to the mall or stores or anything. So I just, you know, got him to sit here and practice. So this turns out to be supremely helpful. This is why it's recommended the spiritual path, especially Sri Shankara. Adi Shankara is that be a renunciate. Be a renunciate. No money. No way to do anything. It's just, you know, basically what you can do is you can sit there and you can affirm. That's what you can do. There's no money to distract yourself, really. It's very helpful. Now, I don't advise anyone to not have shelter and food and clothing and food and the basic necessities, no. But if you happen to be not having money to do anything, you know, you're actually very blessed. So use that to your advantage. Use it to your advantage. Say, all I can do is, you know, sit here. Now, of course, you have to have the discipline not to watch television. See, that's a very bad trap. Because if you don't have any money, you say, oh, it's okay, I can sit here and watch TV. Or just, you know, go to all these websites or something. I can't even go to any website anymore at all. It's just like my YouTube website and maybe my website. And I know everything else is terrible. It's going to pull you in all sorts of different ways. So, it's like, wow, you know, the internet's, you know, not as good as we were told it would be. That's for sure. But, so using time practicing is the best use of time. Best use of time. Affirming. If you haven't got to this leap of faith of, yes, I already know, then build up to it as a phase 1, 2, 3, or 4. The fourth phase is you make this leap of faith into, yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. End of story for the intellect, concepts, thinking. Yes, I already know. I already know this. And I'm just reminding myself I already know this. That's it. Just reminding myself of what I already know. That's all I'm doing. I'm not thinking or analyzing or trying to... No, I don't need to do that. I already know it. I'm just reminding myself that I already know it. Yes, I already know that all knowing is already appearing as spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. I already know this. This is where the world comes up short. This is what I tried to bring into the world. Everybody screamed at me like I was arrogant, you know, as I was young. How dare you be so arrogant? That is absolutely unacceptable. They didn't understand that this is what they needed. This leap of faith is exactly what they needed. It's not arrogance, it's truth. Truth isn't arrogant. And the necessity to do this is a, you know, that the whole thing was spun upside down on me. Says, you can't be that arrogant, you don't already know. Nobody already knows. Yes, everybody already knows. It's just that they're confused about this entrapment situation. not realizing it's all just our imagination, believing that it's real. Yes, I already know. Build up towards that. Phase one, two, three, is you gradually build up toward this, gradually build up toward this. You might start saying, yes, I already know this is, you know, this is divine, but this is nothing else is. So that's the first step. I already know something is. And then, but eventually we get to the realization, everything already is. Yes, I already know that everything is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Phase one, you might start with, I think I know this one thing. And then phase two, maybe, yeah, I know that this one aspect, call it whatever you want, is already, you know, already appearing as spontaneously arising, describing vast, pure spaciousness. And phase three is you start to say that, well, maybe everything is. You know, maybe not. Maybe it's not just one thing, maybe everything is. And then phase four is when you actually make this leap of faith and say, I know that everything is already appearing as spontaneously rising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. So phase one, two, three, four. We're phase four. We're doing phase four right now. It's necessary. The world is on fire. You know, when the world's on fire, you get out of the house, you know? You don't say, well, I know this little thing here isn't on fire, and my or look out the window. Well, I know out that fence out there isn't on fire. You go, huh? And then you start moving a little bit more. You get up and you look at it and say, oh, I know that my neighbor's yard house is not on fire. And then you open the window and you know, you put your head out and you look around and say, well, I know the rest of the neighborhood's not on fire. And then you say, whoa, maybe, you know, I can get out of this window. I say, you know what? I'm already out of this window. You know, don't think, well, how do I get out of this? No, I'm already out of here. You know, I'm already out of here. And then you look and say, oh yeah, I'm free of the house on fire. I'm not there. Because of course the house on fire is just our imagination. But yeah, those are the steps. So I got crushed because ultimately, if someone's insisting, you're arrogant, arrogant, you can say, well, who's telling you that you'd be arrogant if you did this practice? Well, this teacher, you know, they know it's arrogant. Well, send them to me then. Send them to me. Let them come in here and assert that. You start practicing. Don't worry. I'll deal with whatever, whoever's, you know, trying to bully you saying it's arrogant. That's nonsense. And then they come and say, yeah, I'm a big teacher, and that's arrogant to say this. I say, well, who's telling you that you'd be arrogant if you did that? Well, we have this lineage of hundreds of teachers. Well, then send them to me then. Let them all come. I'll set them straight. Okay, so all the teachers and lineage come. Yeah, you can't do that. You got to be part of this lineage. You have to do this, and you can't say that you already know this. And I say, well, who's telling you? You can't say you already know this. Who's telling you that?
the blessing.
They say, well, God is saying that. Well, then send God. You can't send God if that's true. So you send God. Well, you can't do that. It's absolutely arrogant. Well, who's telling you it's absolutely arrogant? God is telling you it's absolutely arrogant? Well, then have God. Don't worry. I'll protect you from God if that's the case. If that's the case. Now set God straight if that's the case. You can't. How dare you say you can set God straight? Well, if God is asserting that, you're saying God is asserting that. Well, if God's asserting a mistake is a mistake, then set God straight if that's necessary. If it's necessary. Well, that's blasphemous, you know. Well, who's telling you it's blasphemous? It's always back to this imaginary God that they're using as an advisor to help figure out how to trick God into this same situation. You say, well, send them. And they say, well, it's God. Well, I said, well, then let God deal with me. You stop bothering me, let God deal with me. If it's arrogant, then I accept whatever God has for me for that, if it truly is arrogant, to say I already know. Then you let God deal with me. The rest of you, don't stop bothering me. I'll take whatever medicine God has to dish out for me. So I was not able to assert this in the face of this collective, global, sanity. Of listening to this imaginary God, which we have only imagined as a consultant, on how to actually trick God, the one and only real God, the one and only real God. We have this this imaginary consultant, God, goddess, to inform us, inform on God, to sneak, to snoop, to inform on God, to tell us what's God's weakness, how can we get God to agree to be entrapped here? So that we can then be prime creator, because God's lesser than us now, so we're greater. And so this insanity, collective insanity of the world, believing that this God is actually the real God, of course they're going to say, how dare you, assert that you already know that this fake God is already, this fake God. Yes, I already know that this fake God is already appearing as a spontaneously arising, indescribably vast, pure spaciousness. So the collective insanity of the world dumps on you, tries to bury you indescribably deep in permanent burialness, which is what happened to me, this is the dynamic of insanity. Once insanity grips you and you have this attitude, yes, I already know, then you think you're so bad that you need to bury yourself like this, you see? So I was not able to keep this assertion when I was young. I hung on to it. I was about 12 years old. I said, I know this is true. I know this is already true. I already know this is true. I already know this too. Yes, I already know. But then all the collective insanity of the world, had me buried. I said, we need to bury you in the deepest of the deep of the deep of the deep of the deepest. Because we can't have God knowing this, that it's all just an imaginary fake. We're just faking it all here. Just evidence to God that this he got you to come here. That this really is a trap. It really is a trap and really will work. And all our work has not been in vain. All our imagination has not been in vain and stuff. So, yeah. This world plays hardball. Insanity plays real hardball. So we cry out for help here, absolutely. But now I'm asserting it, a bit at a time here, getting used to it. And, anyone wants to bring on to all the traditions, bring them on, fine. And who is telling them? That this is arrogant, that they're arrogant if they believe that, if they took this leap of faith, said, yes, I already know. Where are they getting this? It all goes back to this imaginary God, of course, and this whole desire, the scheme we have to be greater than God. That's where it comes from. It's really our own desire to be greater than God that's claiming this is arrogant. Because I'm saying you can't do it. And the desire to be greater than God, that desire is saying, yes, we can do it. And anyone says that we can is totally arrogant. How dare you say we can't do it? And I say, well, God is saying you can't do it, so you can't do it. It's not me that's saying you can't do it, it's God. And you can't change God's will. oh, that must be a fake gun. That's not the gun that we listened to. Well, no. Let's figure out which is the fake gun, which is the real one here. So, yeah. So, the whole thing is to practice like this. That's the whole game. That's the winning game. That's the winning game, is to practice. Don't get into any disputes with anyone about who blah blah blah. Just keep practicing. If they've got the capacity to stop it, then let's see if they can stop it. But in the meantime, keep practicing. If they want to claim they can bring the wrath of God upon it, you know, let them prove their claim. But in the meantime, keep practicing. I already know that all wrath is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all destructivity is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Yes, I already know that all vengeance is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. See, just keep practicing. Just keep practicing. You practice, you win. You don't practice, you lose. It's that simple. Bring this to a close. Go get something to eat. Didn't have anything to eat today. And I hate to bring this to a close because it's so awesome. Hey, yes, I already know that all awesomeness is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast pure spaciousness. Absolutely, all awesomeness is already appearing as spontaneously arising indescribably vast spaciousness. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know. Yes, I already know this. Okay, so if you want to practice something, just you can say, yes, I know I'm already free. Yes, I already, the simplest, yes, I already know. Or I already know. I already know. I already know. Don't say this or that. I already know. Just abide in your I already know-ness. I already know. 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 Okay, very great. That's it.